I know, my love. Come back, rest goes in your pocket. We'll see you later. See y'all later! Hey, Brittany.
Hello, and welcome to Palin Places, Florida. I'm your host, Mr. D. So, hey, let's get this thing in the water. Now, a word from our sponsor. Cast Elements is the leader in design and manufacturing of inflatable kayaks with cutting-edge technology and providing excellent customer service. All of their products are designed to give paddlers the tools they need at a value they deserve. Check them out at advancedelements.com or call toll-free at 866-262-9076. Well, here we go, guys. The trip has started. First stop, Wawa for some foo-foo coffee. Well, guys, I guess your planned trips don't always work out. This is the first time at Wawa they didn't have any beans to grind. I don't know what's going on. So no foo-foo coffee. Maybe I'll run into another Wawa before I hit the expressway. So, hey, we'll be back in a bit. And welcome to Season 6 of Paddling Places Florida Adventures. I'm your host, Mr. D. Hey, and the title of this video, as you've seen up there, is called Wrong Turn. Why is it Wrong Turn? Because, guys, I'm in the state of Georgia. Not Paddling Places Florida, I'm in the state of Georgia. But I tell you what, it's been so hot down in Central Florida, I had to find a place that had cooler temperatures. I checked this place out and it blew my mind. It is peppered with cypress forest on the lake. And there's an old mill that dates way, way back. It's right up here. We want to get that in some shots. So I'm really excited about this place. And we're actually going to make this a two-video event. Right now I'm in Twin City, Georgia. And then next couple days I'll be out in Cordele, I think it's called, Georgia. And I'll be at the Georgia Veterans State Park there, finishing up my five-day road trip. And I'll tell you what, I'm really excited. The temperatures here are really, really nice. It's 64 degrees, guys. I've been suffering down in Central Florida, highs of 88, 93, humidity up off the stratosphere here. I mean, I even had to put a light jacket on when I first left my hotel this morning. I'll tell you, it's awesome. So, hey, let's get this thing in the water. I gotta tell you guys, this did not let me down. This beautiful. I mean, you're seeing all kinds of stuff. Not a lot of wildlife, smaller birds, cardinals, stuff like that. Not what I'm used to in Florida with the, you know, the big, bigger birds like the buzzards and the eagles and I haven't seen anything like that today, egrets, that kind of stuff. But this cypress forest in this lake is absolutely phenomenal. Now I'm getting close to one of the edges. I'm looking over here. It looks like another boat ramp they were talking about, or that's a camping area. That would be cool. They got a camping spot there and they got their own launch right there. That'd be awesome. Since my experience at Sebastian Inlet last year, when I got bit by 52 no-see-ums, and that was 52 and counting, and it took me almost 3 weeks to recover from all of that, I've decided that camping is not for me. They came in and just ate me alive. And then I found out later that Sebastian Inlet is known for no-see-ums and chiggers and all kinds of other nasty critters. But you know, I just said, you know, I'm not going to do this. And you know, to try to get a camping spot in Florida during the winter months is almost impossible, because all the snowbirds come down, and I'm getting an echo. That's weird. All this is bouncing my voice back. Wow. Anyway, wow, this place is beautiful. Look how dark it is in here. We're gonna go and paddle this a little bit. I wanna show you how dark this is, that my voice is bouncing back from these trees. They are really dense in here. Look at this, wow, this is crazy. Beautiful, but crazy. There, it gives you a good view of what I'm seeing. This place is phenomenal. That's another campsite over there. But guys, I gotta tell you, this place did not disappoint. It was about a 6.5 hour drive for me from Central Florida to Twin City. Actually, I went to Swainsboro. Man, it's beautiful. Gosh, dog, look at all those trees, guys. Okay. Look at all these trees. I mean, this is all in the water, out on the lake itself. What intrigued me was the cypress forest, or the on-water forest is what intrigued me, and the old mill. And we got some shots of that earlier. We're gonna go back down there. Somebody's cooking breakfast. I can smell it. So the campgrounds actually line all this, apparently both sides, I'm not sure. But I know this side that I'm on right now is a lot of campgrounds and stuff like that. But I've got to admit, this is absolutely breathtaking. So anyway, hey, we'll be back in a minute.
Must have been Mr. Olympian with all that amplitude. How come you always load your Pentax when I'm in the nude? We ought to have a birthday party.
Well, hey guys, we are at the top end of what they call Watson Pond. That's where we are today. And I'll tell you what, it's not huge. It's not as big as I thought it was going to be, but all the trees, cypress forests, they're everywhere. And you're just in awe the whole time you're paddling. It's just, it's phenomenal. I mean, I'm just kind of just cruising around. It's beautiful. I had to look at my GPS to figure out where I was, because I was just paddling through the forests and all this kind of stuff and getting some photos and stuff. Just like I'm doing now, I'm paddling through a couple of a smaller forest right now. Don't want that spider in my boat. And anyway, I was able to get some really cool shots. Now I'm going out on the flat side of Watson Pond, and I guess it goes up this way and then everything heads back down, and it feeds into that the mill where there's falls, I think. So we're gonna go check that out, and then we're gonna go check out the park and see what's offered here. Again, the name of this park is George L. Smith State Park, and it is in, they say it's in Twin City, Georgia. It's just actually below and to the left of it when you're looking at the map. Anyway, I'm almost at the top of Watson's Pond right now. It looks like that's it. I don't know how it's fed, because if there's falls, something's feeding this. I don't know. But anyway, I hope you're enjoying this video. I know I am, man. It is so great to be back on the water and not sweating. I mean, it's starting to warm up a little bit right now, but I wouldn't even call this. This in Florida would be a perfect day. Right now, the weather is great. The wind is minimal, maybe 3 to 5. And I'm just paddling around. I am at the top of Watson's Pond right now. I'm just checking to make sure. Yep, I'm at the top of it now. And like I said, it's a, you know, all in all, you're gonna pull in about 4 miles. If you go through all the different forests, you could paddle as much as 6. But it's not a straight long paddle. It's a big, kind of a jagged pear looking shape. But it's phenomenal, guys. It's phenomenal. What a, man. I'm so glad that I am back on the water. That's all I can say. So anyway, hey guys, we're gonna continue our trek and go down the backside of this now and make our way back to the mill. And then eventually we're gonna stop this one and then go in and check out the mill, check out the falls, and get some photos and stuff like that and some footage from there. So hey, we'll be back in a bit.
Oh, battery's dead.
I had the 360 GoPro Max 360 camera all set up. It was sitting on a floating tripod, and I don't know what happened, but it had 6% battery, so I don't know if I accidentally turned it on when I put it in my GoPro case. I don't know, but whatever happened was I had to switch from the GoPro 360 and put the Insta 360 on the floating tripod, because I wanted the Insta 360 on the 106-inch pole. So I've made do with this one, and again, this is the opening season, so you're always going to have a few bugs. And one thing I didn't do, which I should have done last night, I had more than enough time, was to check the batteries on all the cameras. So when I go back to the car after I get done paddling, I'm going to put a fresh battery into the 360. I think somebody's launching down by where I launched at. Looks like it. Anyway, this place is absolutely just beautiful. Yeah, we got kayakers coming in over on the other side there. Hey guys, we're gonna back out of here and see if we can get some shots of the mill, because this is beautiful. So hey, we'll be back in a bit.
I think it does, but I can't really tell. But I think it drops off right there. You guys can hear it. Oh yeah, I can see it down below. So that goes into a river after that, and it's right underneath the mill, and it drops underneath the mill. And we'll get some shots of that after we get done with our paddle.
All right, guys, we are off the water now, and we are heading over to the mill. I did talk with the rangers here at the park, and they said that's the dam. It is the spillover on the dam, which is kind of cool, and it's open, so I can go ahead and do my thing. So I'm really excited about this. The paddle itself was just way pleasurable. Met two people in a K2 that were just so nice. Chatted with them, they just came off the water, so I went over and chatted with them some more. That's what I do. So this is actually the museum, so I'm gonna get some information on what this is all about. And I see a big rattlesnake sign here, so I'm not too sure about walking in here, but I'm gonna find out. So hey, we'll be back in a minute. right, guys, we are going to wrap it up out here at our season 6 opener at George L. Smith State Park, Twin City, Georgia. And it was a blast. It was beautiful. I loved everything about it. Took a tour of the mill, and that used to be a cotton gin is what it was. And the waterfall is basically a spillway from where they dammed this thing up. And the feed, because I didn't know about how it was fed, it's called Wolf Branch. And it's like 4 or 5 different creeks that fill into this and then flow down below. So it's really, really cool. Absolutely a plus place to go to. I mean, wow. The cypress forest trees and all that kind of good stuff was just fabulous. Everything about this place was cool. So hey, we'll see you on the next one. We'll be right back.